amazing, primed and ready to go and chase a little paper. I give up thanks in the world to me creator. Long as I stay strong, it's gonna make me greater. This is what I came with, assembly was required. Not a battery included, I needed power. Didn't know that in myself was untapped power. Now I'm in at the moment.
So the World Economic Forum has been in the headlines this week. It seems that they have released another research report, this one centered around the interoperability of central bank digital currencies. However, what's even more interesting is the players involved with this report, guys. My name is Wade Teamer, and you're watching the Digit Hustle News. Now, if you've been with the channel for a while, you know that we keep an eye on the World Economic Forum. They are at the top of the proverbial pyramid right now as we go through this transition. Some people call it the greatest transfer of wealth in human history, and I am inclined to agree. Now, the World Economic Forum, if you don't know, is basically led by a gentleman by the name of Charles Schwab. It's a weird name, but they have their own YouTube channel, guys. And you can go there, type World Economic Forum on YouTube. You can see all of the agendas that they're pushing. And you'll see that this urge towards digitization, tokenization, all of that stuff, it's coming from them. Okay. The CBDCs, the digital currencies, that which are supposed to be separate from CBDCs, all of this digital transformation, guys, it's coming from them. So I make it a point to keep my eye on the World Economic Forum. Now, like I said, they just released this report. This report is about 300 pages long. Of course, we won't dig into it, but there is a piece of information that I do want to share with you guys. Now, bear with me. This is going to take probably about 5 seconds, but I have to find, again, the contributing authors, guys, because that is where the juicy information is. Now, this is the Digital Currency Governance Consortium. Okay. This convenes more than 85 organizations from the public, private, and civil society and academia to provide a global perspective towards addressing high priority policy and governance issues surrounding new forms of digital currency. So this group that the World Economic Forum has put together is focused on ushering in this next phase of digital finance. Okay. Now, what I find interesting are the contributing authors. Okay. Now, again, bear with me as we scroll through this. Of course, you know how I do, guys. If you want a link to this, I'll put it down in the description, or you can send me, well, you know what? I think I'll just, you guys send me an email. We'll do just like we did with the Bank of America report. I want to build an email list because I have further plans for that in the future, guys. That's going to be fun for all of us. But let's see. Okay, we're here at the Governance Consortium Steering Committee. Okay, we'll see big names right away, right off the top. CEO Charlotte Hogg, Europe Visa Incorporated. Okay, we also have the head of BIS Innovation Hub, that's the Bank of International Settlements, a very important player. We also have the president of MasterCard. We have the president of the Financial Action Task Force, president of Western Union. Man, this list gets deep, guys. Minister of Information, Communication, Technology, and Innovation out of Rwanda. The chairman and CEO of Ant Group, Ant Financial. The senior minister of Singapore, Monetary Authority of Singapore. President of PayPal, CEO of Fidelity. Member of the European Parliament. I'm naming these names and these players, guys, to give you an idea of who's running this whole picture, okay? But as we move further down, we start to see members from specific blockchains, okay? Starting with Simon Chantry, co-founder and chief information officer for Bit Barbados. Now, we just saw Barbados in the headlines. They're getting into the metaverse from a municipal standpoint. Bit, however, is actually a Stellar Lumens company. And if we scroll further down just a little bit, we will see that Seth Hertlin, head of policy and government relations for the Stellar Development Foundation, is also on this list, guys. Also with him, we have head of official sector engagement from C Labs. That's Celo. Okay. Now, continuing to scroll down, guys, we got some more important players from around the world. PayPal, Standard Chartered Bank from the United Kingdom, Team 8. We got some people from Hyper, Ledger, Linux, some players from Brazil, Israel, so forth and so on. So this is definitely has global players involved, guys. But what I want to show you is XRP or Ripple's contribution. Okay. You got to go all the way down this list here, but we will find this man. Okay. We will find this man. Now, I had this issue yesterday. Probably should have booked Mark this, but want to show you here. Oh, we even have Deloitte's on here, guys. So pretty much, if you go to the World Economic Forum's website, guys, you will see a list a lot similar to this, all of their partner organizations, so forth and so on, guys. So Ripple was on here. Ripple is on here, guys. You can see it. It's just so many names on this list. There are even some people from Aave. That's interesting. But I wanted to show you that, guys, to show you the relationships that are coming down from the top. That's essentially why I'm sharing this piece of the document with you. More Stellar Development, UNICEF, so forth and so on. Project Fellow, Center for the Fourth Industrial Revolution. This stuff is massive, guys. Again, if you want to dig deeper into this and, you know, have this report for your records, because all of this information is pertinent. It's really pertinent, guys. But let's get into these articles really quick and get the information that they're offering, guys. But two CBDCs have been formally introduced and are recognized by international regulators. However, more are unfolding by the day or functioning on an unofficial basis. Naturally, the next question they must tackle is interoperability. To that end, the World Economic Forum published its findings as part of the Digital Currency Governance Consortium White Paper Series. This paper compared China's CBDC to the Swedish risk bank e-krona and the Bank of Thailand CBDC. It's worth noting that China and Sweden's CBDCs are meant for retail use. Thailand CBDC was aimed at business-to-business payments. The three digital currencies shared some of the other features and design principles. However, interoperability was where things took a turn. The paper concluded that China's CBDC required a specialized wallet which can link to other payment systems. On an international scale, they confirmed that China was working on the MCBDC bridge project for cross-border remittances and business-to-business use case, guys. So this is just basically a summary of the report, guys, and some of the this one where it talks about Ripple. Okay, good. I'm glad we have this here. But apart from CBDCs, it is vital to keep an eye on crypto companies working with central banks to help them develop their own CBDCs. One example of this is Ripple's partnership with Bhutan's Royal Monetary Authority. So in that document, again, guys, you'll see all the participating players. But the reason why I'm sharing this information with you guys is, again, to highlight the relationship between Stellar Lumens, Ripple, and Celo when it comes to the CBDC conversation all the way from the top. The World Economic Forum is at the top of the pyramid, guys. But they also released a story showing how blockchains are changing humanitarian aid. This is where we'll mention Celo, okay? But definitions vary, but it broadly... A humanitarian stablecoin has broad definitions, but it refers to donations and aid made possible by fintech platforms and fiat-pegged crypto. A humanitarian stablecoin could mean instant cross-border aid without a loss in value. This concept has the potential to change the way countries deal with disasters and conflict. For this part, the World Economic Forum released a white paper that takes a closer look at various humanitarian stable coins and tokens in existence today to better understand their advantages and disadvantages. Now, in this report, guys, in this first paragraph, you're going to get some names right away that you recognize. In the particular PDF, the World Economic Forum studied Circle's partnership, that very same one, USDC, with Artem, the Diem payment system, okay? Grameen Foundation and the Celo platform, as well as the Inter-American Development Bank and LACC chain blockchain network. These organizations are working towards the development of stablecoins for aid in diverse parts of the world. Though many projects are in the conceptual stage, the World Economic Forum found that some benefits could include dodging oppressive regimes and beating the effects of hyperinflation, guys. Now, currently, Celo is working with a company called Impact Market, okay? With Impact Market, they are essentially exercising universal basic income in communities in different parts of the world, okay? So, again, we want to make sure that we keep an eye on the World Economic Forum and where they keep their eye. All year, I have heard just three projects, with the exception of the six that they announced. However, if you go back to that report, and I have a video on that as well, we saw that Solana was mentioned, XRP, Stellar Lumens, Celo, and Algorand. Okay, Solana has already had its run up. So, are we getting ready to see the run up for the rest of these coins? Cardano also had a run up too. Okay, we still need an XRP run up. We still need a Stellar run up. So, and a Celo run up. That will be good. But the important message, especially for this video, guys, to take away from is the relationship between these three assets and the World Economic Forum. Okay, we already know of another asset that is very, very close with the World Economic Forum. But when it comes to CBDCs, the next payment system, these are the projects, these are the blockchains that I believe that are going to come from the top. They're definitely going to be in the top. All of the developments we saw play out this year, okay? We already saw the groundwork, the foundation layer be placed for these assets to do what they do. And now this report from the World Economic Forum just essentially confirms it, guys. So again, Digital Currency Governance Consortium White Paper Series. If you want to Google that, of course, you can also send me an email. I will get the link sent right over to you guys. But these reports are always an interesting read. They're always very interesting to read, guys, because they contain information in them that isn't being publicly discussed. It is just not. So that's why I'm glad I'm here, guys. I'm glad I can give that to you. But that's all I got for this video, guys. Of course, if you found value in it, you know what to do. Hit the like, subscribe, ring the notification bell. Also, feel free to get down at me in the comments, guys. I want the comment section to work like a networking event all the time. Every video, guys, we are going to build a network. We're going to build a network here. I want people to start to share ideas, what they want to do with blockchain, what they're already doing with blockchain, because, guys, we have a very, 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 very prominent opportunity to change our futures, to change the narrative for our future, guys. So that's why I'm putting things in formation and I'm encouraging the networking down in the comments, guys, because not only is that going to separate this channel, this community from everybody else, just imagine the power that we could have, though, once we start coming together. I've had a dream about it the last 3 days, and it's very exciting. It's very exciting. So with all that being said, though, guys, the focus to take away from this video, World Economic Forum, Ripple, Stellar Lumens, and Celo. Okay, that's the ticket right there, guys. But as always, you know what I'm going to tell you. Have a great day. Have a prosperous day. But most importantly, we making this money. I'll see y'all in the next one. We'll be right back.